in a hospital bed, stars circling around my head, and a plaster cast on just about every bone. But the doctor said I'd be just fine. These things just take a little time. And 3 weeks later, he let me go back home. But I'd laid in bed 3 weeks just thinking, I believe I could have took him if I hadn't been drinking. So the next time we meet, I won't be on a binge. 'Cause I hadn't been the same since we had that fight. And I see that cyclone in my dreams at night. And I'll never be satisfied till I get revenge. Well, the first thing my wife said when I got home was,
you better leave the cyclone alone.
She said I might not be so lucky next time. So I said to her, beg your pardon, ma'am, but it wasn't you that got body slammed. And then I changed the subject, 'cause I done made up my mind. So I called up Bill, told him my plan. All he said was,
right on, man, I'd do the same darn thing if it'd been me. You see, it all happened so fast. When that car door slammed, it must have broke something, 'cause the door lock's jammed, and you's already down and he's gone time I got free.
Bill said,
since you're thinking about taking him again, I know two old boys that weigh 210, and they'd wade through wildcats to fight a circle saw. Yeah, they both lift weights, so you know they're mean, and the four of us would make a heck of a team. We might not win, but we'd darn sure fight to a draw.
Well, we talked it over, and they said they's willing. They'd stop at nothing short of a killing. Said,
Hoss, we'll back you as long as you want to fight.
So I checked around at a few of the bars and found out where all the wrestling stars hung out after the matches every Wednesday night. Well, we got there early the following week and got a table where I could see the street and waited for the Blue Cyclone to hit the door. Yeah, and after a while, he finally appeared, sat down at the bar and ordered a beer, and he barely took a sip before I stepped to the middle of the floor. I yelled, hey, Cyclone, remember me? I'm the guy you put to sleep, only this time you can see I'm not alone. See them two big dudes over there? And the cyclone looks at over where? And I turned around, I'm a son of a gun, man's gone. Well, the cyclone looked at me and grinned. He said, okay, punk, here we go again. Seems to me that some guys never learn. Then he waded through those tables and chairs, put a full Nelson on me and grabbed my hair. And when he threw me to the floor, I'm starting to get concerned. Then came a barrage of judo chops, and I'm begging somebody to call the cops before the cyclone could commit a mortal crime. I breathed a sigh of relief when I heard that ambulance siren scream, 'cause I'd be dead now if they hadn't gotten their own time. Well, the next thing I remember, they're carrying me in, and the doctor said, oh, now you again. I said, Doc, how long do you think it'll be this time? He said, boy, if you don't leave the cyclone alone, one of these days you ain't going home. You'll need the undertaker's services, not mine.
Blue Cyclone.
He's the meanest wrestler the ring has ever known. He'll make you groan, he'll make you moan, he'll lay you prone and break your bones. He's the Blue Cyclone.